Let us begin our today's class. Last class we have studied addition of large numbers and how can we apply the same in real life situations, isn't it? Today we are going to study addition by estimation. What is meant by estimation? You have already studied how to round off the given numbers nearest to tens and also nearest to hundreds we have studied. Here also, instead of finding the actual sum, we can round off the numbers and we can find the estimated sum. And the estimated sum is little bit close to the actual sum. When we are converting the given numbers or when we are rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, then the sum will be closest to the actual sum. Okay, so let us see how to round off the numbers. We have studied. Once again, we can revise the same. Okay, how can we round off the numbers? Then how to find the estimated sum as well as the actual sum. Okay, let us see the question. First one is, fourth question, checkpoint, question number 5 actually. Calculate the following sums by estimation in two ways. First one to the nearest tens. And next one to the nearest hundreds. And compare with actual addition. Actual addition means actual sum. Compare your answers with your actual sum. So let us see our answers. So the first one, given number is 28,956. 28,956 plus 76,538. These are the two numbers given to us. So in the first column, teacher started with the actual sum. Actual sum means we needn't want to do anything. Write the numbers column wise. Column wise means one after the other. Then you just add the same. 6 plus 8, 14, 1 remainder. 1 balance, so carry over to next column. 1 plus 5, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 5, 14, 1. Then 1 plus 8, 9, 9 plus 6, 15, carry over 1. So 1 plus 2, 3, 7 plus 3, 10. So our actual sum is by putting commas, first 3 digits, then 2 digits. 1,5,494 is our original sum or actual sum. Then let us move to the second column. We have to find estimated sum first by rounding off the numbers to the nearest tens. And secondly, find the sum by rounding off the given numbers to the nearest hundreds. Once again, teacher will explain how to round off. So teacher has taken the numbers, given numbers first, 28,956, 76,538 teacher has taken. Then for rounding off to nearest tens, what you have to do is round off the first digit. And at the same time, write it as 0. Okay, circle the ones digit and write it as 0. Just below you write 0. Then you think about the number. Think here the given number or circled number is more than 5. When it is more than 5, what we have to do? Add 1 to the previous number. Add 1 to the previous number. So 5 becomes 6. Teacher has written 5 as 6. 9 has no change. 8 has no change. 2 has no change. So the given number has been rounded up to 28,960 now. Similarly, 76,538. Circle the ones digit and write it as 0. Circle and write it as 0. Then you think about the circled one. If it is equal to 5 or more than 5, add 1 to the previous number. So previous number is 3. And when you are adding 1 to 3, what will happen? 4. Then 5 bring down, 6 bring down, 7 you bring down. Then you add the two numbers together. Here teacher has added it directly, but in your notebook, write the numbers one by one, add the sum. Okay, 0 plus 0, 0, 10 balance, 6, 6 plus 9, 15, 1 balance, 7, 7 plus 8, 15, 1 balance, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 7, 10. So our new sum or estimated sum is 1,5,500. Little bit more than this actual sum. Okay, is it clear to you? because see what I am explaining, rounding off to nearest 10. In your class, most of them have made incorrect answers in this section. Okay, for our examination, 17th one, the last one was rounding off the numbers to nearest 10s. So only some of the students answered neatly. For the remaining students has made mistaken. Okay, that's why in order to make it clear, teacher is explaining once again. Is it clear now? Let us move to the other section, rounding off to nearest hundreds. So look at the board now. Now we are rounding off the numbers to the nearest hundred and we are going to find the estimated sum mark, isn't it? So let us see how to round off the given numbers to nearest tens are. Okay, nearest hundred. How can we do this? Let us see. So here teacher has written the number, first number 28956. Nearest 100 varumbo we need two digits as zeros needed. Okay, 100 consists of two zeros, or 100 as two zeros. So here also we need two zeros venam. And here you have to circle the second digit, that is 10th digit, you have to circle it. Here 10th digit aanu circle cheyandathu. Then look at here. This digit is, and replace first two by zeros, already teacher has replaced it. Okay. Then you think about whether it is 5, more than 5, add 1 to the previous digit. Now, if we add 1, say, 9 plus 1, we end up 0, and 1 more balance. Actually, this is carry over 1. This is carry over 1. Now, 8 become 9 and 2. Okay, so answer is 29,000. Why? Because this number is 9. So by adding 1, we have 10. 0 teacher has written, what we do with the remaining 1? Carry over. Carry over is giving 8 plus 1 as 9. 29,000. Similarly, in the second case, here also, replace first 2 digit by zeros and circle the 10th digit. But here 10th digit is less than 5. So there is no change goes to 5, 6, 7. There is no change goes to 5, 6 and 7. Previous case it was 5. 5 or more than 5 given. Add 1 to the previous digit. So when you are adding 9 plus 1 it is 10. 0 teacher has written that remaining 1 carry over to the next column. So 1 plus 8 we have 9. 2 has no change, bring through. Then you add these two numbers together in order to get the estimated sum. In order to get estimated sum, just add these numbers. 0, 0, 5 plus 0, 5, 9 plus 6, 15, 1 balance. Appa ethra aanu? So what we have? 1,05,500. Okay, then they told us to compare these estimated sums with the actuals. So you just want to write whether it is more than or less than. And here we can see that here estimated sum is more than the actual sum, is more than the actual sum. Okay, estimated sum is more than the actual sum. Okay, estimated sum is more than the actual sum. Is it clear? Let us go to second question. Ready? Yes. See, our B question is, fifth one, B question is, the sum of 98,601 plus 4,572 given. For our convenience, teacher has taken three columns. First column, teacher has written actual sum. Second and third columns are given for estimated sum. For estimated sum, but in two different ways. Which are the two different ways? First one is nearest to tens. Rounding of the numbers nearest to tens. And here, nearest to hundreds, then add. Okay, so let us. The first one is no change, 98601. Keep a little bit distance between these two and write out. 4572. While writing the numbers, keep the places same. Ones digit in ones digit column, then tens in that column, like that you have to keep the numbers neatly, then only you will get a correct sum. 1 plus 2 3, 7 plus 0 7, 6 plus 5 11, one balance, take it here. 1 plus 8 9, 9 plus 4 is 13, then one balance. 1 plus 9 is 10 for us. So 1,3,173 is the correct sum or actual sum or original sum. Let us move to nearest to tens case. Nearest to 10 ayirode teacher ivide underline cheyana digit ne. Underline the ones digit and replace it by 0. Replace it cheyidu. Then look at this one. 1 is less than 5. So there is no change goes to remaining numbers. Remaining digits are same. Okay, there is no change goes to remaining digit. Underline the first digit, that is ones digit. Replace it by 0. That replace the number. Okay. The teacher has to see 1 is less than 5. No change goes to 0, 6, 8, 9. The teacher has written. And the second case here, underline the ones digit, replace it by 0. That replace the digit. And 2 is again less than 5. So no change goes to 7, 5, 4. You add these two to get the estimated sum. But 0 plus 0, 0 on 7 plus 11 on 1 balance on 13 on again 1 balance 10. Answer 3. 1,3,170 rounded down okay has been rounded down to the actual sum. But previous question more than actual sum, but here estimated sum is less than the actual sum. Let us see what will happen to the next column. Appo ivide hundreds vannu already rendu cases aayirukonde oru digit teacher and you know, underline chedu. Next digit teacher and you circle chedu. So the second digit or tens digit you circle it. Then replace first two digits at all. First two digit by zeros. Then you think about the circled one. Circled one is less than 5. So no change goes to remaining digits. 6, 8, 9, same itself. Similarly here also, round off tens digit and replace first two digit by zeros, replaced it. And it is 7, and circled one is 7, more than 5. So what we do? Add 1 to the previous number, add 1 to the previous number. So 5 becomes 6, 4 has no change, you add the numbers. 0, 0, 12. And here it is 1. Carry over 1. So 13, 1 balance. 10. So how much coming? 1,3,200. Here the sum estimated to the nearest tens is less than the actual sum, less than the actual sum, but nearest to hundreds is more than the actual sum. Is more than the actual sum. Just comparison idea. In your textbook they have asked you how much less than, how much greater than, like that way. Okay. That is not needed to us. This much enough. Okay. Just compare them. Whether they are equal, greater than or less than. That's enough to us. But here we can see that 170 is less than 173. And here 200 is greater than 173. If you didn't want to use sentence wise, you can use numbers also. For example, 1,03,170 is less than actual sum. Okay. So instead of writing sentence, you can use short forms. Okay. This is also good to you. and here 1,03,200 is greater than actual sum. That is also a good idea. Okay, instead of writing these sentences, we can avoid and we can write mathematical formulas or equations. That's enough. Mathematical statements enough. Is it clear? Okay, let us move to our next question. What is given? See the question. Here sixth one teacher is not writing the question. You have to copy the question from your textbook. Okay. Branches of the bank X equal to, name of the bank is given as capital letter X. X is equal to 2,630 given to us. That of bank Y equal to, number of branches of bank Y equal to 1,986. Branches of the bank Z equal to 1,493 given. We have to find the total number of branches of these banks. And what we have to do? Find the actual sum and also using the estimated sum. How to estimate the sum? By rounding off these numbers to the nearest hundred sum. Hundreds only are. Okay, previous question it was both cases we have to find actual and estimated sum, isn't it? But here we have to consider the actual sum and estimated sum using by rounding off the given numbers to the nearest hundred sum. So let us see how to answer the same. So teacher has taken two columns. First column actual sum. But write the numbers one by one. 2630, 1986. All the digits, all the numbers are same digits. So there is no problem arises. We can fill it clearly. 6 plus 3, 9. Then 20, balance 2, 8, 17, 21, balance 2. How much coming? 6. Don't copy the answer directly. Sometimes teacher may have mistakes. Okay. So do it yourself and make it sure. 11, 20, 2, 8, 17, 4, 21, 4 plus 5 plus 1, 6. Okay. So 6,109 actual sum. Finished. But we have to find by rounding off to the nearest hundreds. Now, rounding off, teacher will underline. Okay, tens digit will underline. After like, rounding off, we will circle. What do we do? Circle or underline. So, after circling, replace the first two digits by zeros. First two digits are zeros. Look at the circled one. Circled one is less than 5. Less than 5 ammo. No change goes to 2,600. Here, replace the first two digit by zeros, replace that. But it is 8 and greater than which one? 5 and greater than 5 and again. You add 1 to the 19 and 19 plus 1 is giving 2,000 at the mark. Karna, if you add 1 to 9, 10 and balance 1. Up carry over to 1, we have 2,000. Similarly, here, replace first two digit by zeros 9. Yeah, 9 is more than 5. So what we have to do? Add 1 to 5. Add 1 to 5 means it, sorry, 1 to 4 means it is 5 and 1 has no change. Then you add these numbers together. First zeros are 11 and 1 balance. Appo namukku 6 1. Appo 6,100. So which one is more? Actual sum is greater than, instead of using sentence, what we can use? Symbol at the end. Actual sum greater than estimated sum. Here, actual sum is greater than estimated sum. And it is finished. The section of estimated sum has been completed. Only three questions are there, but go through the questions clearly. Then only you will get the idea how to estimate the numbers. Okay.